Friends, welcome back to my channel. I have this 10 ohm resistor. It is wire wound resistor, 25 watts, and I have 12 volt DC. If you connect this 10 ohm resistor to any power supply, here we have 12 volt, and if you connect ampere meter here or here, any place, how much current will flow from this resistor? What is voltage? What is current? What is power? Voltage, current, resistance, power. These four items we will discuss in this video. Now I will connect this multimeter as an ampere meter, DC ampere. To measure the current, positive voltage are connected to the multimeter ampere socket, 10 ampere socket, and positive voltage after passing through this multimeter, the current will move to this resistance, and after resistance it will pass to battery negative terminal. Positive terminal here, current is passing through this multimeter here. It is flowing 1.2 ampere current. We applied 12 volt to 10 ohm resistance. The current is 1.2 ampere. Let's discuss. We applied voltage 12 volt. Current is 1.2 ampere. The resistance 10 ohm. How we can prove with equation? This is a question from my viewer. He asked me, sir, please explain voltage, current, resistance and power. What is voltage? Anytime when we have a difference of 6.242 10 raised to power 18 electrons, we have these two terminals. One is called positive, second is called negative. When there is a difference of 6.242 10 raised to power 18 electrons, it will call 1 volt. It is a potential difference. What is electron? Electron is negative carrier. It is potential difference. It is a unit of charge, coulomb. When there is a difference of 6.242 10 raised to power 18 electrons, how there is difference? This point have more electrons, so this area will become negative. If here is deficiency of the same value, it will become positive. Why? Because when we pull out the negative charge, what remains there? Positive charge. The atom will become positively charged, and here excess of electrons, deficient pole is positive, where excess of electrons negative pole. So difference of this number of electrons between two terminals will called 1 coulomb. That is equal to 1 volt. That is potential difference between two terminals. Now if we connect this 1 volt, if we connect these voltage, these number of electrons to a conductor material, and it allows to move, to flow these number of electrons in 1 second. Here are two items. Number of electrons in 1 second, it will called 1 ampere. If this number of electrons will move from any part of circuit in 1 second, it will called 1 ampere current is flowing. And if we apply 1 volt to a conductor, and this conductor allows this number of electrons to flow in 1 second, the resistance will called 1 ohm. Now, if we increase the voltage, the current will increase. If we will increase the voltage, the current will increase. But if we decrease the resistance, the current will increase. If we increase the resistance, current will decrease. So these are opposite to each other. Voltage and resistor are inversely proportional. Voltage and current are directly proportional. If you apply 1 volt and the current flows 1 ampere, the power will 1 watt. We apply to 1 ohm resistance, the current flows 1 ampere, the power will 1 watt. Sorry, here we applied 1 volt to 1 ohm resistance, it will cause to flow 1 ampere current. When 1 ampere current will flow, the power will generated 1 watt. What is power? Power is the efficiency of this voltage level to produce some effective work in this conductor, in this material. When we apply 1 volt to a 1 ohm resistance, it will dissipate power, it will generate heat 1 watt. So we can say it is the efficiency to do a work. If we have voltage 12 volt, we have resistance that is 10 ohm. How we can calculate current? I is equal to V over R. 12 divided by 10 is equal to 1.2 ampere, which we measured on this meter, it was 1.2 ampere. If we know the voltage and we know the current, voltage are 12 volt, current is 1.2 ampere, then R is equal to V over I. Voltage are 12 volt, current is 1.2 ampere, resistance will 10 ohm. And if we have resistance 10 ohm and the current flows 1.2 ampere, V is equal to I into R. 1.2 ampere, 10 ohm, so it is 12 volt. When we have voltage resistance, we can calculate the current. Voltage divided by resistance, ampere. Voltage divided by ampere, resistance. Current multiplied by resistance, we will take voltage, power. We have voltage 12 volt, current is 1.2 ampere. Here we have these two values. So we will find P is equal to V into I. 12, 1.2 ampere, 12 volt. So it is 14.4 watt. The second calculation, P, power we can calculate. We have voltage. We have the voltage value is 12 volt and resistance is 10 ohm. By using two values, we can calculate P is equal to V square R. 12 square divided by 10, it is 14.4 watt. We calculated power here, power here. Power is defined, the power generated in this resistor will equal to the square of the current flowing multiply with the resistor value. So P is equal to I, ampere. How much ampere? 1.2 ampere and resistance is 10 ohm. P is equal to I square R as we defined. P is equal to 1.2 square 10. So it is 14.4 watt. These are the conditions. If we have these two values, we can find the power. If we have these two values, we can find the power. If we have these two values, we can calculate power. We calculated the current here. Now we can calculate current with the other values. We know the power. If we have power value, that is 14.4 watt, we calculated. In any circuit, we know the wattage and we know the voltage. Voltage are 12 volt. We want to know about the current. So I is equal to P over V. So power is 14.4 divided with 12 volts. Current is 1.2 ampere. Now we can calculate the current if we know the power and if we know the resistor value. Power is 14.4 watt. Resistor value is 10 ohm in this circuit. I is equal to P over R. 14.4 divided by 10. 14.4 watt divided by 10 whole square root. So it is 1.2 ampere. 1.2 ampere. We calculated the current here. First condition, when we have resistance and power, when we have power and voltage, when we have resistance and voltage. Three different methods are used to calculate the current. If you know the power, power is 14.4 watt, and we know the current value, that is 1.2 ampere. How we can calculate the resistor directly? It is P over I square. 14.4 divided by 1.2 square, it is 10 ohms, the resistor value. And we can calculate the resistor. If you know the power, power is 14.4 watt, and we know the voltage, that are 12 volt. How we can find the resistance? That is V square over P. So V square, 12 square, divided by 14.4. 12 square divided by 14.4, so it is 10 ohm. If you know the power, power is 14.4 watt, and we know the current. Current is 1.2 ampere. We can find the voltage. 14.4 divided by 1.2, so it is 12 volt. If you know the power, power is 14.4 watt, and we know the resistor. Resistor is 10 ohm, so it is P into R. So it is 14.4, 10 ohm, 14.4 multiplied by 10 ohms, it is 12 volts. If you want to find voltage, current, power, resistance, we have every section we have three formulas. If you want to find the current, current will be in ampere, voltage divided by resistance, ampere. Power divided by voltage, ampere. Square root P over R, ampere. And we proved all these formulas here. If you want to find resistance, power and current, if you have two values, power and current, you can find resistance. If you have voltage and current, resistance. Voltage and power, you can directly calculate resistance. If you want to determine voltage, power with current, power with resistance, current with resistance. So these are the four items. If we have two values, we can find the third one and we can determine the fourth one. Basically, it is interconnected to each other. If we have two values, we have resistor value and we know that 1.2 ampere current is flowing. At that time, we can calculate the voltage 10 ohm and the current is flowing 1.2 ampere. We can calculate directly and we can find using this circle how we can say that it is providing power. Now I will collect this thermocouple and we will connect here. Now it is 46 degrees. We will check. Now the current is flowing. its temperature is increasing. When the temperature will increase, its internal resistance will decrease. We can see the temperature is increasing. It is now 74, 76 degrees, and the current is also increasing. We can monitor the current. In this circuit, the first condition is the temperature must remain constant. It is now, we provided the voltage, the current is flowing, and this current is producing power. So that is the reason it is becoming hot. This time the temperature is 9800 degree. When it is 100 degree, we can see the current is also increasing because it is producing power in this resistance. I will add the link of these calculations in the video description. You can download it. If the video is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.